Hello dear students, welcome to Dr. Espinac Medici classes. In today's lecture, let us try to learn the treatment of hypertension. And in the previous classes, I have discussed about pathogenesis and pharmacology of antihypertensive drugs. And in this lecture, let us understand the pharmacotherapy of hypertension. So before understanding the treatment of hypertension, first let us diagnose the patient with primary or secondary hypertension. So the patients who are on secondary hypertension, they should be first treated with the underlying cause. Okay, if the patient is suffering from diabetes and he got hypertension secondary to diabetes, so we have to control the diabetes of the patient, and by that we can reduce the hypertension too. So diagnosis is very important. And listen guys, hypertension is usually caused by three major factors. The first factor is vasoconstriction. Vasoconstriction is the one of the major factor that reduces the lumen of the blood vessels and increases the blood pressure. Okay, this is the one factor, and these factors should be reduced due to vasodilators, calcium channel blockers or ACE inhibitors. Okay, and the second factor is we have increased blood volume. Blood volume is usually increased due to many factors, like due to increased salt intake will increase the blood volume. Okay, so we have to reduce the salt, and this is also can be treated by giving diuretics that increases the excretion of sodium as well as the excess water present in the blood volume, and by that we can reduce the hypertension of the patient. And the third factor is increased activity of heart. So usually due to increased sympathetic activity, due to increased corticosteroid hormones, due to adrenaline, aldosterone activity, all these substances will increase the inotropy, positive inotropy, positive gonotropy and positive chronotropy of the heart, and by that it increases blood pressure. So the blood pressure which is caused due to cardiovascular causes, we can prescribe beta blockers, we can prescribe calcium channel blockers, and we can also give ACE inhibitors. ACE inhibitors will directly reduce the sympathetic activity. Okay, and so these are the some drug of choice which reduces the heart related factors, and blood volume is reduced due to diuretics, and blood vessel factor is reduced due to ACE inhibitors and calcium channel blockers, and some other drugs also will directly or indirectly they reduces these three factors. So we have to reduce these three factors so that we can manage the hypertension. Remember guys, after diagnosis of the patient, so let us start the therapy now. So before starting the therapy, we should ask the patient to maintain the diet plan. Okay, first thing we should not treat the patient with pharmacotherapy. We should go with non-pharmacotherapy. Ask the patient to reduce weight. Weight is very important. We have to ask the patient to reduce weight, reduce salt intake of the patient. So sodium intake should be reduced, and ask the patient to be physically active. Patient should have physically active, and restriction of junk foods like fatty food items should be reduced. So fat intake should be reduced, and if the patient has diabetes, let them control the diabetes very well due to insulin or some other oral hypoglycemic drugs. And if they are sedentary, ask the patients to have some physical activities in the mornings or in the evenings. So first make the patient to treat with non-pharmacological therapy, and if this doesn't work, we have to shift to pharmacotherapy. So in the pharmacotherapy, let us directly start with the drugs. Actually, in the pharmacotherapy, first we should go with monotherapy. And before starting the pharmacotherapy of hypertension, first let us start with ACE inhibitors. We have to go with ACE inhibitors or ARBs. Anyways, ACE inhibitors will have many adverse effects, and to overcome those adverse effects, we usually give ARBs. And in the ACE inhibitors, we have enalapril, captopril as good drugs. Captopril. And in ARBs, we have telmisartan. Telmisartan and losartan are some of the examples of ARBs. And the first line drug is ACE inhibitors. And remember, guys, while giving ACE inhibitors, we have to manage the adverse drug reactions of the patient. Just check the patient is having dry cough. Cough is commonly seen with ACE inhibitors. And if the patient is pregnant, please don't prescribe ACE inhibitors, because ACE and ARBs are highly teratogenic property. And sometimes ACE inhibitors causes proteinuria, and they may damage kidney failure. They may cause kidney failure, and they causes hyperkalemia. So hyperkalemia patients also, we should not prescribe ACE inhibitors. And they causes hypersensitive reactions, cough, itchiness, and neutropenia is common, another ADR for ACE inhibitors. So we have many ADRs for ACE inhibitors. So we have to manage the adverse drug reactions, and we have to give the drug. But first line drug is ACE inhibitors. And in pregnancy, we should avoid ACE inhibitors. And ACE inhibitors should be started for one or two months. And after 1 month, if the treatment is not effective, if the patient is not getting treated, go with second therapy. We have to start with the second drug. So that is called dual therapy. And in dual therapy, usually we have ACE inhibitor plus thiazide diuretics. So ACE inhibitor is commonly given with thiazide diuretics. And remember, thiazide diuretics will cause hypokalemia, whereas ACE inhibitors causes hyperkalemia. So that ADR will be reduced, and it is a good combination, which usually 90% of the patients were treated with this combination. And even after giving this combination, we should start with triple therapy. So in the triple therapy, we usually have thiazide diuretic, ACE inhibitors, and calcium channel blocker. So thiazide diuretic, ACE or ARB, and calcium channel blocker is given in the triple therapy. And triple therapy is the major one which usually treats all the patients. So this is the final therapy actually. So if the patient is not treated with these drugs, we should consider them that they are resistant to all these drugs, and they may undergo hypertensive crisis. And for hypertensive crisis, we have another guidelines to manage the hypertension. So this is the triple therapy. And remember, guys, while giving with ACE inhibitors or calcium channel blockers or ARBs, diuretic should be always given in combination. One diuretic is commonly given. So if you are prescribing CCB as first line drug, calcium channel blocker, if the patient is not treated, you can add one diuretic. Thiazide diuretic should be added with calcium channel blocker. And if you are starting first with ACE inhibitors, if the patient is not treated, go with thiazide diuretic in combination. Okay, and always do not prescribe one ACE inhibitor and ARBs. ACEs and ARBs should not be given in combination, because they may aggravate the property, hypotensive action. So always we have to go with the different class of drug. Okay, the major, the first line combinations, first line drugs can be given are ACE inhibitors, ARBs, calcium channel blockers, and thiazides. And when you're giving any one of these three drugs, you have to add thiazide as the combination. Okay, and you can also give any two of these drugs along with thiazide. Okay, so these are the combinations. And in the older patients, calcium channel blockers and thiazides are the best combinations which is used as antihypertensive drugs in older patients. And major combination is one diuretic is added with beta blocker or vasodilator or methyl dopa or ACE inhibitor, as we have discussed. Okay, with the diuretic, beta blocker can be given, Vasodilator can be given, and centrally acting drugs methyl dopa can be given, and AC inhibitors are also given. Just remember this combination. And remember guys, this is very very important. Methyl dopa, beta blockers. In the beta blockers we have atenolol. In the beta blockers we have atenolol, only atenolol. The first thing is, in pregnancy methyl dopa is the drug of choice. The first point, methyl dopa is the very safest drug in pregnancy, and it can be given. If the patient is not treated with methyl dopa, we can go with beta blockers. And in the beta blockers, atenolol is the drug of choice, and this atenolol should be given only at third trimester, after or in the third trimester. Okay, so beta blockers, atenolol can be given in third trimester. And remember guys, IV labetalol also can be given, which is a safe drug in pregnancy. And if even these drugs are not effective, you can, from the calcium channel blockers, we have nifedipine. And oral or sublingual, yeah, nifedipine is usually formulated as oral or sublingual form, and nifedipine can be given in pregnancy, which is a safest drug. And remember guys, in pregnancy most of the patients will have severe convulsions. Eclampsia, preeclampsia is commonly seen. So in those patients we have to prescribe magnesium sulfate for as an anticonvulsive agent, which is a safe drug in pregnancy. So in the pregnancy, methyl dopa is safest drug. In beta blockers, labetalol can be given, and nifedipine calcium channel blocker can be given. And if these drugs, if they are not treated or if they are not effective, we have to go with sodium nitroprusside. If they are not treated, the alternative drug is sodium nitroprusside, which is not a safest drug, but this will reduce the hypertensive crisis conditions in the pregnancy to manage or to reduce the complications of the hypertension. So sodium nitroprusside. And remember guys, this is very very important point, AC inhibitors and ARBs are strictly contraindicated in pregnancy because they cause they have high teratogenic property. And diuretics and clonidine, even clonidine is a centrally acting drug which is along with methyl dopa. Most of us think that methyl dopa and clonidine are safest drugs in pregnancy, but not. Clonidine is not a safest drug. And even hydralazine is also strictly contraindicated in pregnancy. ACE inhibitors, ARBs, diuretics, clonidine and hydralazine are strictly contraindicated in pregnancy. Remember these class of drugs. Okay, so these are some of the combinations and treatment in the older patients and in the pregnant people. So these are some of the combinations. And remember guys, hypertension treatment is should be very effective. If the treatment is not given, if the hypertension is not treated, patient may have many complications like cardiovascular complications, blood vessels will be ruptured, patient will have retinopathy, nephropathy, sometimes kidney may be damaged, and patient will have neuropathy. So these are the complications, and to treat these complications we must reduce the BP of the patient. Okay, so BP treatment is very very important. And along with the pharmacotherapy, most of the patients will not have proper efficacy, even then pharmacotherapy is given. So in that patients we should strictly monitor lifestyle modifications, and sodium restrictions should be given, and diet modifications, physical activity should be trained well. Okay, so we have to maintain both pharmacotherapy and non-pharmacotherapy for better efficacy of the drug. And we have a condition called hypertensive crisis, which has a high risk of developing cerebral hemorrhage. So patient may have cerebral hemorrhage, blood vessels will be ruptured in the brain, and they may cause stroke. So hypertension crisis is very dangerous, and that hypertensive crisis is treated usually with IV formulations and the drugs which have a rapid onset of action. So from the IV drugs we have sodium nitroprusside is one of the drug of choice in hypertensive crisis, and usually 1 to 10 mcg per kg is given as IV form. And we have nitroglycerin, even it is available as IV. And this is sodium nitroprusside is given in oral form also through sublingual route and oral form. And nitroglycerin is given in IV. And hydralazine 5 to 10 mg IV is drug of choice in most of the hypertensive crisis patients. We have labetalol. Labetalol is the beta blocker which is formulated as IV form. More and other most of the beta blockers are available in oral form, and labetalol is the major drug which is given through IV form. And we have nifedipine. Nifedipine is having rapid onset of action, and anyways its duration of action is also very low. And it is formulated as sublingual form, and 10 mg sublingual tablet can be given, and which reduces hypertensive crisis. And we have enalapril. It is a ACE inhibitor. Okay, so enalapril is also the major or unique drug from the ACE inhibitors, and 1.25 to 5 mg can be given through IV form. So these are some of the IV and rapid acting drugs which are commonly given for hypertensive crisis. And we have some contraindications. Antihypertensive drugs which are strictly contraindicated in certain disease conditions. Remember guys, asthma and COPD is the major condition which is associated with hypertension, and in this condition we should strictly contraindicate non-selective beta blockers like propranolol. Okay, beta blockers are strictly contraindicated in asthma, and in angina patient vasodilators should be contraindicated, and patients with congestive cardiac failure and myocardial infarction, calcium channel blockers are contraindicated, and patient with severe bradycardia, even in that conditions we have to contraindicate beta blockers and verapamil. Verapamil is a non-dihydropyridine which mainly acts on the heart and reduces the contractions of the heart or heart velocity, and in that condition, in bradycardia condition, we have to contraindicate beta blockers and verapamil. And in diabetes, remember guys, potassium sparing diuretics are strictly contraindicated in diabetes mellitus. And potassium sparing diuretics can be given along with loop diuretics and thiazide diuretics. Okay. And there is a condition called hyperlipidemia. And in hyperlipidemia, thiazide diuretics, mainly thiazide diuretics, causes hyperlipidemic reactions. So thiazide diuretics are strictly contraindicated in hyperlipidemia, and beta blockers are also contraindicated in hyperlipidemic conditions. And in CKD, remember guys, in CKD beta blockers are strictly contraindicated, but in some patients we can give metoprolol which is having vasodilatory property. So metoprolol can sometimes be given in CKD patients, and most of the patients we don't prescribe beta blockers in the CKD. So these are some of the drug of choice and the drugs which are given in the hypertension patients. And remember guys, this is just for education, this is just for writing in the examination, and I did not follow any of the guidelines. I have just mentioned some drug of choices and some drugs how can be treated in hypertension patients. And if this video helps you, please don't forget to subscribe it and share with your friends, and comment if any new information you have, and the information what I don't know I learn from you also guys. So please like our video, and listen, this is not a guideline. So this therapy should not be given for any patients without having proper pharmacological knowledge. Okay, and thank you for watching.